Faster enn to, eller brøsj?
Ja, ass. Jeg pelmer seg sykt, ass.
Delicious!
Very moist. Very good stuff.
Fish. Nice. That's a nice sized little fish.
That's a good sprout.
Yeah.
Decent size. I'm sorry, buddy. Nice feeling. I've been fishing for about 5 minutes. And yeah.
Yeah.
That's cool. I guess that's... we have some fish for tonight.
Yeah.
I'm gonna cook this and have a delicious little meal.
That's Marius's luck.
Yes.
I never get fish.
This is typical my luck. So Jonathan, you're next.
Yeah, I guess so.
Go.
All right,
fishing stick.
Let's go fish.
Let's go. Woo!
Good morning, world.
Good morning, guys.
How are you? We're back on a little trip.
Yes.
Our summer trip. It's a tradition now that we drive out for 1 week and explore parts of Norway that we've never been. We find ourselves in Geiranger right now. We walked for, I guess, 4 hours yesterday.
Yeah, we took just a normal trip up with a small backpack just for the exploring. We were not sure if we can park our car there over the night.
Yeah.
So we went back, asked the guide or the people that worked on the restaurant down at Vesterås Gård. Cannot park there, by the way. But for all the guys that want to sleep here or come to Geiranger, you have to take a trip up here and camp up here. It's amazing up here. And you can find some spots at the side of the road that if there are no M signs as for a meeting place, you can park your car there.
Yeah.
And you can walk up and sleep wherever you want here.
So when we walked here with our small backpacks yesterday, with that was just supposed to be a day hike. We found this place with huge mountains on both of our sides, and you might hear it. There's a river right down here that runs all the way down to Geiranger Fjord. And this place was just magic, and we both got like Lord of the Rings feelings when we walked here, and we put on some Lord of the Rings music while we walked.
We felt like Frodo and Sam just walking up to Mount Doom, and yeah, it was an incredible feeling walking here.
We just had to camp here, so we walked down to the car again, equipped us with more gear and our bigger backpacks, and then we walked up again and found this kind of top on a rock, and we put our tent here.
Yeah, this is right next to Vesteråsätra, which you can find from the Vesterås Gård. You can see the sign, and you just follow the path and you get up here.
There's DNT paths and signs everywhere. That's a Norwegian route.
Yesterday we found ourselves in Jerkin, which is between Dovre and Dovrefjell.
Yeah, that was a nice experience.
And we also got some fish.
Marius
nice.
Did?
Yeah.
I never get fish. I had two on the hook, but they didn't swallow the hook, so couldn't get them up. But that was the first day. Let's see if we can catch more.
Yeah, I'm going to try the river afterwards and see if I'm lucky here.
We don't stress now. We found this spot, and we don't have like we don't have a time where we have to be somewhere, so it's just up to us, and that's what's so good about this trip, that we have 1 week, one car and two backpacks. We can do whatever we want.
We can do what the fuck we want. We spend a lot of time in the car because it takes hours to get from A to B here.
Yeah, sure.
And yesterday we had an amazing car trip. We went through Trollveggen and then came to Trollstigen, and then we come to Valdal, took the boat over to Geiranger.
Yeah.
Holy shit, what a trip.
It's really beautiful. And you get to see Norway at its best. And if you ever wonder where to go in Norway, definitely recommend Geiranger. And if you want to check out a video or a film from this place, there's a movie, a Norwegian movie called Bølgen, which is filmed here in Geiranger. And it's about a huge mountain that is moving 15 centimeters per year. And that's a fact. And the movie is like, if what would happen if the mountain would fall?
The consequences of the mountain falling through and down the water is that there is going to be a huge wave that is about 50 to 80 meters high, and it's going to blow out the entire Geiranger, and they have set up a huge alarm system, and they got people on the job 24/7, to secure and make sure that the mountain is intact.
Yeah.
So that's what the movie is about, and it's a catastrophic movie, and it's actually quite good.
It is. We watched it while we were in
Dovre.
Yeah.
Just to get the hype up for Geiranger and see if we could compare Geiranger in the movie and in real life. And
We can, of course.
Of course we can.
I mean, it's special effects in movies that we cannot see here in real life, but the mountains that they film and the waters and the waterfalls, everything, it's we can compare it with the movie. And that's cool.
Yeah. It's amazing.
Yeah.
But now we need to save some battery space.
Yeah. See you guys later on.
Morning guys, today me and Jonathan are hiking Besseggen, which you can see behind me, taking the ferry from the other side here, and we are taking the boat over to Memuro, and we are walking up the whole way. One way the route is 14 kilometers, the hike is around 5 to 8 hours. And the highest point is around 1,704 meters above sea level. So, it's one of Norway's most famous hikes, and there are a lot of tourists here. The parking lot is stacked with cars, and there are loads of buses here. So our ferry is going around 10 a.m. So we are now making breakfast and packing up and getting on our way. So we'll see you guys on the top. Hell yeah.